Hi everyone! In today's video, I'm going to show you how to embed any of our AvePDF widgets to your website. You might want to facilitate your customer journey by helping them convert or compress the files to fit your size or format requirements. More than 50 widgets are available on our website. The good news is that it is very easy for you to embed our tools to make your website user-friendly. First, you need to create an account for free on avpdf.com. Click on Sign Up, enter your email and password. Then, check your emails to confirm your email address. Log into your account. You can now choose one or multiple widgets you want to embed in your website. Here we'll use the hypercompress widget for the demonstration. Go on and click the hypercompress PDF widget on the home page. Click on the embed icon on the bottom right. Here is the code you will need to copy and paste to your web page. Now, you need to edit your webpage HTML code to paste the piece of code. Here is the webpage I want to modify. I want the widgets to appear inside the AvePDF demo box and I will show you how to proceed right now. Simply open your HTML code and paste the widget code where you want it to appear. Here I will replace the AvePDF demo box I showed you with the widget code. Now, let's see how it is displaying on my web page. It is working the same as it does on our AvePDF website. Let's try to hypercompress a file. All documents processed with AvePDF are automatically deleted from our servers after 30 minutes. If your users prefer, they can delete the file manually right after processing by clicking the bin icon. If you want to upload the same widget multiple times on the same web page, you will need to modify the widget ID in the HTML code. I'm going to show that to you right now. Here we want to replace the second AvePDF demo box with the same hypercompressed widget. Let's paste the same piece of code we used for the first widget. Now we are going to modify the widget ID that is currently AvePDF container ID. We will put here as an example AvePDF container ID2, so you can just add at the end the number 2, but you can put any other text for the ID as long as it is different from the other widget ID that you put in the first place. Make sure to edit also the ID in here with the same ID you just put previously, that is in our case AvePDF container ID2. Don't forget to save your HTML file to see the update on your website. Let's go back to our website. You can see both widgets are displaying and are responsive. You can also change the size of the widget in your CSS. For any question, feel free to contact us. Have fun using AvePDF tools.